With me today from Faron Pharmaceuticals here in the studio, I'm joined by Markku Jalkanen. Markku, good morning.
Good morning. Good to be back. Thank you.
Good to see you. Your results out this morning. I suppose let's start with Clevegen. What's the latest here, Markku? What are the latest developments?
As we have told, we are increasing the dosing of Clevegen, and we have some early, really interesting discoveries already done. First of all, we can see the immune switch in the immune system of those patients we are administering Clevegen. Secondly, we have an early responder already with the low dosings, and we are now heading up in the dosing, so we actually should have even more effective effects in the near future. So it's really exciting time for us to get the readout of those patients.
And the readouts will be when?
Well, gradually it's ongoing all the time because it's an open study,
right.
So every patient can be followed rather closely. Of course, the tumor imaging kind of a data comes at the time when they are taken, and they cannot take them all the time. So it's gradually, maybe once a month, every patient will be imaged, and then we know what actually will happen into those patients. But clearly we have a responder at the moment because we can really see the metastasis shrinking out patients feeling much better. It really looks good.
And so colorectal cancer, that's been chosen as the first expansion.
That was a surprise for us that we do have this really now in the colorectal cancer. And as there is no treatment for this, especially for these MSI negative patients, and having a now responder and some other immune type cell changes are so evident, I think it's really time to look at them seriously. It doesn't mean that we do not take in the other cohorts as well, but we will focus at the beginning really to colorectal cancer type.
And what might some of these other cohorts be?
Spleen, pancreas, maybe even melanoma, ovaria. So the ones where we know that these clever one positive myeloid cells are very evident in those tumors.
It's probably just worth pointing out these colorectal cancer patients, these are patients in which they've tried a number of other treatments with no success.
In our trial, we see that they have already received like 6-7 different lines of treatments, and they come to our trial in very good bad condition, which means that you really have to carefully see what is happening on them. And obviously it helps a lot to have blood samples tested all the time when we have administration ongoing on the patients.
And from what you've seen so far, it's encouraging.
It's absolutely encouraging.
And so this expansion study, when might that get underway?
We hope to be able to do it after the dose selection. In other words, we have an optimal dose where we believe that we can help the patients most. And that's the second half of this year.
Right, so in H2.
Yeah.
What about those partnering discussions? How are those coming along?
Well, let's put it this way, that the results we have published and the previous discussions we have had in the past, they are very intensified at the moment. And we actually are really heading with the very optimistic minds to the ASCO meeting in early June, where we have a number of different meetings. Everybody knows that immuno-oncology is a new way of treating it, but we don't have all the weapons yet available. So to have a combination of activation of immune system and to remove the immune suppressive elements more properly, we will believe is the winner. And I think we are in the position of having really good start for these negotiations and partnering possibilities.
Because at the moment, of course, you own 100%
of Clevegen. Yeah, that's correct.
And so how would the ideal partnership form, how would that take shape? Or is it too early to say?
It may depend so much on the partner. You may be looking for a profit-sharing model where you just agree on certain conditions, and we may have a wish to have some of the commercial rights in some of the territories by our own. So that really depends on the discussions.
But crucially, you'd be looking for a partner to pay future trials and studies.
Well, especially if there are a number of separate cohorts we can actually expand, then we really need to set up a significant higher number of sites we have today. By the way, this week we are assuming that the first UK patient will be recruited to the trial at the Royal Marsden, so good luck for them as well. It's an opening here. But then to move other sites in Europe and especially to US, because then under the US IND we can go directly to talk FDA as well.
Right. And you'd be looking at, is it phase 2B at some point next year?
The classification of this here art, because here you actually may need only like 25% efficacy result. So how big trial you need to run really to convince the authorities if there is no tox problem. That remains to be seen, but somehow phase one, phase two conversion will take place next year.
Would it be unusual? Efficacy of 25%?
Within the cancer drugs it's seen previously as well, so this is not unique in that way. So if you have early efficacy, we should actually follow that signal and move on really to increase the evidence that it's safe and efficacy continues throughout the whole group.
So have you got an ideal time frame in which you'd like to have a partnership deal sewn up?
No, but sometimes also the partner candidates would like to come and influence on the trial structures and further designs. So earlier they actually do their own decision better and more fruitful actually future we'll have when we move on. And of course, you need to also remember that some of them may have a standalone desire for new treatment then or combination with previous existing PD-1 inhibitors or other inhibitors. So the whole field is up there really waiting to have additional tools really to fight the cancer.
But the interest so far from the industry, it's been positive.
It's just increasing all the time. I'm happy to say that.
What about Traumakine? Markku, where are we at there?
We have sorted out the problem like we said earlier, and now we know what to do next. And we will take that proposal to the regulators to get their advice. And if that advice is a positive and we have a structure for the next trial, we then move on probably through the small pilot and upfront and then expand that to a global trial.
Right.
So that's eventually the plan. But the main thing is here is to avoid the corticosteroid use, especially at the same time when interferon beta is given to them. That's completely detrimental and that eventually should be looked very seriously.
Because you had the results recently from the Japan study.
That's no surprises. Very correct. They pretty much looked like we saw already in the interest trial here in Europe.
So remind us what are the next steps here for Traumakine? What are you working on?
Building the package for the regulators to get the advice.
Right.
And our team next week will be in US really to talk to the investigators over there to agree on the structure of the protocol and the study. And then we move on and go into FDA because we already have an open IND over there.
Right. So the year itself, 12 months of good progress?
I would say that the mood is totally different than last year. Of course, the failure of the interest trial. But we said that we will fix this and we have pretty much done. So I am so proud of the staff what we have, the remaining staff. We have reduced the number, recovering this fast and this well from that.
Are you in other partnering discussions with Traumakine?
They all are waiting the regulatory advice. So we are not pushing that.
Right.
Yeah. Let's get that first and then discuss.
And a bit of cash in the bank as well?
Well, we have some cash to move to the end of the third quarter at the moment, and we are looking alternatives really to provide additional resources to the end and maybe beyond even that. So I'm really positive about that as well.
Very good. Well, as always, a lot to look out for. Markku, thanks for coming in. Nice
Thank
to see you.
Thank you. Yeah.